ready?
Big night if the UFC has descended upon Anaheim, California. Good to have you with us from Honda Center here tonight. We have had so many big championship nights in this building. I remember UFC 214, three title fights on the line. A lot to be contested here tonight.
When the UFC goes to Anaheim, they make sure they bring big fight cards, three title fights at UFC 214. What history are you going to make tonight in this arena where so many titles have changed hands?
Oh, she's really using her reach advantage to great effect here tonight. Lands the punch.
Punch over the top.
She blocked the punch. Inside leg kick. Oh, combination lands for her there. It's hard to recall a past fight of hers in which her striking has looked this fluid in her.
She's sharp as a tack. Sharp as a tack. Everything is landing. She's doing a great job.
Swing and a miss with that punch by Zhang Weili. Stuffs the takedown shot there. How good is her takedown D? Wow, what a head kick. So both girls landing right out of the chute. Zhang gets hit by that leg kick. You may want to start checking some of these. Just a slip there. Well, she's got a good jab. Missed with it there. Oh, effective strike there by Zhang Weili. And they separate.
Body kick. What a
point. Back to the clinch we go, and an immediate trip there to get the takedown. So really a case of pick your poison when you're in a clinch setting with this fight.
Oh, she does such a great job of overwhelming you and giving you way too much to process that before you know it, you're on your back from a beautiful trip like that. Right hand punch to the clinch.
So just over 20 total strikes, which have landed for Weili Zhang. She's going back to that patented straight right hand, unable to connect.
Great punch.
Oh. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Well, she was long on grappling experience. Zhang's looking for that arm triangle.
Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Wow, there is just a viciousness with which she operates here on the ground as she continues to get the ground and pound game going. She might get a finish here.
She's looking for the finish. She's so good at dictating these ground exchanges, and she's doing a fantastic job of building posture to try to land that kill shot to the top.
All right, she's got north-south position now on top. Is it just more a dominant ground control type of situation, or are you trying to work for a submission?
You can hit the north-south choke, which is you start to sag your weight away, drop your shoulder into their throat, and just really cut off the oxygen with the choke. It's a very difficult thing to finish, but it will wear on your opponent and weigh them down and wear them out.
Pinpoint jab placement there, and a nice job to take advantage of her edge and reach.
Good punch.
Oh, she's really starting to put together some significant body shots here, attacking both sides now. Oh, yes, it is a lost art in mixed martial arts. Not just the jab, but the double chin.
I mean, a beautiful double jab. That thing's throwing right from the chin, too.
I'm not sure her striking has ever looked better, DC, finding the range with relative ease here tonight.
She's doing a great job of timing everything. She is seeing everything out there. Nice strike.
Final seconds here. Right hook to the body.
Another
takedown lands. Oh, nice job by her there. You see how strong she is. Her opponent's trying to control posture, unable to do so.
Now she can get to work and put the money in the bank with that ground and pound.
Money in the bank. All right, let's check out some of the action in that previous round. DC, she certainly kept the stat trackers busy with all those takedowns.
All those takedowns and some really nice takedowns. She did a great job of level changing, getting into her opponent, not allowing her opponent to defend before she can secure her takedown.
All right, so she was able to take her opponent down really at will in the previous round. We'll see if her opponent has made the proper adjustments here.
It's gonna be very difficult because the way that she attacks is so diverse. She's never just doing one thing and giving a pattern.
Right.
It's always like, it's like algebra, right? Her opponent's doing basic mathematics, but she's doing algebra. She's giving her so much information.
She did not miss there. This could be the end.
Hurt her so bad with that big head kick. I don't know how she's standing.
All right, full guard now, DC. She's on the bottom. What is she trying to do?
Well, she's got to throw up submission to try to put her opponent on awareness. And these submissions will be used to reverse the position. Even if it gets defended, it will create space for her to try to get back to her feet or maybe to steal a sweep and trick her opponent.
All right, so the ground and pound strikes continue to land. She's not staying busy for the sake of it. She is doling out damage.
She's landing a lot of punishing ground and pound, and this is gonna really zap her opponent as they get back to the feet.
Well, you gotta stay busy from the bottom position. Can't falter here. She's doing a nice job. Changes her stance. She missed with that jab. Educated jab right there from Zhang Wei Li. This is a competitive division, but certainly looks like a fighter who could reign for some time.
I mean, China's first UFC champion, and Wei Li is the person that you want to see carrying the flag for her country. She has everything. She's even learned to speak English now. She understands the importance of drawing people in and capturing the imagination of the fight fans around the world.
Her corner men are losing their minds. She got stunned by that strike earlier in the round, but just hasn't gotten herself mentally or physically back in the fight.
You never know how your fighter is going to react to adversity. Right now, she has not done a good job of it.
All right, she's landed some pretty good shots here tonight, but still DC unable to string any solid combinations together.
I just don't believe she's confident in being in there. She's very aware of her opponent's power, so it's making her limit her activity on the inside. Throw that out the window. You're the faster fighter, you're successful. Let those combinations string together.
Oh, lands a flush elbow. And there's a takedown attempt by her there, DC, but she's unable to get it.
She's unable to get it. Her opponent is ready and expecting the attempt. She has to mix it up, she has to trick her. Go to a different shot if she's gonna secure this takedown. Big punch from the clinch.
Oh, beautifully placed knee. Whitney gets the takedown. Let's see how she chooses to proceed from here. Man, look at the redness appearing on the left side of her body there. That's starting to really add up. Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground. An attack and armbar.
Just be a matter of time. The sheer will is really remarkable to watch. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitancy whatsoever here in round two. She has clearly found her rhythm and range. Misses with the right hand. Effective punch there by Zhang Wei Li. Oh! Huge kick to the head.
Beautiful level change.
Oh, John, that was so nice. What a beautiful takeout.
Pretty significant welt to the left side. Good ground and pound by her here. She felt like she could finish the fight with her ground strikes tonight and might be well on her way here.
I mean, John, I believe it after watching the ground and pound that she's landing in this part of the fight.
Gets up again here, but hurting. 20 seconds now remain in the round.
Nice kick.
She's starting to put together some significant body work here, and these are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. All right, round three coming up next. All right, so there's the end of the round, and in terms of offensive wrestling execution, she had it all going there.
Yeah, she had it all working. She did everything she wanted to do. She was racing to position. Once she got to a leg, she didn't pause. She didn't stop. She went right to the finishes that she needed in order to get the fight to the ground. I mean, that was a great display of offensive wrestling.
All right, so we'll see how it goes here in this next round. She was able to take her down a bunch of times in that previous round, and I'm not sure she's going to be able to stop it here.
Well, no. Nothing tells you that it's going to be any different between round one and round two, because it wasn't close. It's not like she was shooting, having to change the attacks,
right,
having to move on from one, two, three, four, five things. It was first shot, go to a takedown. Second shot, get a takedown. Third shot, get a takedown. It was over and over and over. Takedown after takedown, and that's why she's ahead on the scorecard.
Well, we told you off the top, she's got the longer reach and certainly made good use of it in landing that straight punch there. And now they are throwing both sides with conviction.
Ooh, what a punch.
Oh, she lands a combination now. Nice volume of strikes, and it was hard to find a miss in there. She's on point.
Volume is very important, but the accuracy stands out above all in that combination.
Oh, she continues to work the body here to great effect.
Level change, leg, finish the takedown. Great job. Nice stick with the right hand.
All right, she postures up here, DC. We'll see if she can get those ground strikes.
Watch for the huge elbows that she's known for.
Well, you got to try to stay busy off of your back. She's doing it here. Nice punch.
Nice stick with the right hand.
Oh, keeping busy here off of her back. Nice offense from the bottom.
Get into half guard. Let's go.
Chong's back in half guard.
Nice stick with the right hand. Right in the side control, yep. Nice stick with the right hand.
Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all the right directions. Another nice transition by her there.
She's moving a lot, but every movement has purpose.
Chong's going for a choke here.
Now it's starting to slip under the neck.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. This might just be a matter of time. Wow. We have crossed the midpoint of this one.
Hard scramble, hard scramble.
That's a nice job by her there to reverse the position on the ground.
She was in trouble, now she is the one handing out the punishment. Great change of position very quickly.
Can you believe she is able to keep up this output just as she did in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes here and not slowing down whatsoever? She looks like she could go 10 hard fives if need be tonight.
Nice.
Let's get some points. Let's get that takedown going.
All the damage to that leg hits toll. You see her limping a little bit. Big right hook attempt, but she misses. Chong gets in the clinch.
If your opponent has you in the clinch, pulling down on your head, landing punch after punch, you have got to clear that collar tie reach.
Huge connection by her there.
Massive shot lands. How's she gonna try to find the next shot that'll finish the fight?
Well, you gotta think at this stage of things, there is a wide margin on the judges' scorecard. She has landed a ton of significant strikes in what is her best performance today.
This is the best we've ever seen her look. She did a great job of fighting at her pace, dictating control in all of the exchanges, and she landed punches in bunches.
Quainly gets the double leg takedown. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing.
Chong's looking for that arm triangle now. Her movement here on the ground, right? Shades of Ray Borg just transitioning so beautiful.
Yeah, she's so good at transitions and movement. Her ability is unmatched.
Well, maybe some panic setting in for her opponent as she continues to land with the ground and pound.
She cannot deal with the pressure of the top fighter. She's so good at finding her strikes.
And that'll do it. 15 minutes in the books. So there's the horn. We're going to look back at some of the highlights here. Chief among them, the submission attempt that ends up a near miss.
There is no holding with this young lady. She doesn't take you down to hold and stall. The moment you hit the ground, she's chasing submissions. She's trying to end the fight, and she almost got it done in that exchange.
All right, next round is underway. In the previous round, it looked like maybe tap or snap, tap or nap. Neither. Let me fight on.
I mean, it's amazing that she was able to withstand that attempt. I thought it was over. Nice body kick right under the elbow. I mean, that is a big shot to the head. I cannot believe she's still standing.
Looking really bad at this point in time. You know she's tough enough to fight through it, but that is gonna hurt big time in the morning.
Oh, big punch lands.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed with that one.
Beautiful body kick land right under the elbow.
Back and forth we go here.
Great punch landed with so much power.
Well, she whiffs on the straight right hand. Zhang Weili with an entry here and able to connect on that one too. Beautifully done.
I watched Weili hit pad, and I was amazed at the hand speed that she displayed in that short video clip. This is a fantastic striker, an unbelievable performer, and a great UFC champion.
Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed without. Consistently finding a home for that left punch.
That was a thudding leg kick.
Finds a home for the left hand there. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
When you're in a clinch, you can pull down the head and land beautiful punches to the head.
And they separate. Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there.
Ooh, big shot lands.
Wow, is she applying a lot of pressure here? I'm not sure how much her opponent can take. Clear sense of urgency here as she tries to make sure the judges stay out of it. Well, she told us in our fighter meeting on Thursday the double leg would be there. It was certainly there in that instance.
J.A., she said they're not built like her. Right. They can't stand up to the freight train double, and she just got it off. Great job, great technique, great confidence in that position.
Oh, she gives up her back here. So a case of pick your poison, and now she's going to have to work hard defensively to prevent the finish.
Well, she's got to protect her neck. That's the first thing. She's got to really be aware of where her opponent's arms are. If her opponents get in.
Chong's looking for that arm triangle.
There it is.
Nicely done. Strong bottom work here, staying busy.
Don't want to be though.
Well, back to her feet here, but man, is she hurting.
Look at this. What a strong
fighter there. I knocked out. Her opponent still stands.
She still stands. She's got to get on her bike. She's got to get out to the center of the octagon. Find some space so that she can evade her opponent from finishing her.
Man, she's got some good ground and pound and putting that part of her game to good use tonight.
She's putting it to great use, just really damaging from the top position.
Well, she's been good tonight, but she missed with that one. Man, high volume of strikes in this round as she continues to land and pour it on. It's amazing that she has been able to maintain this aggression with her striking throughout this fight. Try to establish that jab.
She's got a back. Oh, there it is.
Seconds.
10 seconds on the clock.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up.
Look at the force behind that leg kick.
Buzzer sounds for the end of round four, 20 minutes in the books. All right, so a lot of high-level striking in that last round, but the big shot, of course, to the head that stunned her opponent, nearly got her out of it.
I mean, she hurt her bad. I can't believe that we are going to another round. I thought it was over. She landed it perfectly. Usually that's enough to end a fight. Unfortunately, the round goes on. Let's see what happens.
So here it is, folks, fifth and final round.
Liver kick, if you take those kicks, it's gonna shut your body off.
Well, how impressive is this young woman? High volume of strikes in the previous round and picking up exactly where she left off here and not really showing any signs of slowing down. She looks like she could go 10 hard fives tonight if need be.
Big kick land.
So the straight punch is there for her.
Fantastic takedown land.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition game.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
Chong's trying for a submission here. Half guard position for her here, and this is a spot where we've seen her have a lot of wild success in previous fights.
She has a tremendous amount of success in this position because she's so knowledgeable. She keeps the right side underhook and she just goes to work with that left arm. She's posting and elbowing. She's building her posture and punching. There are just so many different ways for her to score strikes from this position.
3 minutes now to go in the fight. Oh, nice strike on the ground for it. Pretty impressive ground and pound display here, champ.
She's doing a great job of finding the right time to take her ground and pound opportunities.
Chong's back in full mount. guard position for her here. And if you're the bottom fighter, this is truly a case of pick your poison.
Yeah, you got to pick your poison. And if you're on the bottom, you got to be trying to find a way to escape that bottom leg. You cannot allow your opponent, you cannot allow her to sit on your leg and just throw big damaging strikes. You got to make sure you're on an elbow control, an underhook, and getting back to your feet.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground.
Certainly a strong front runner for fight of the night as we go down to the wire here between these two combatants.
They're both so skilled. They're both so prepared.
Shot she's thrown tonight. Her opponent's hurt.
Beautiful placement on that hook. What a great job of finding such a massive shot.
Oh, pretty good job there posturing up and landing with the ground and pound. She has been very efficient in this situation tonight.
Very efficient and very accurate. Hats off to her. This is a terrible position. Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time.
Wow.
All right, side control for her now. And you know how heavy she stays with all of that upper body strength. We'll see what she can do from here.
Well, she's got great upper body strength, and that's why she passes. Because she doesn't necessarily feel she needs the legs to control her opponents on the ground. So she goes to side control and hopes that you give your back. That's
right.
Why you see she has so many rear naked choke submissions.
I would never give you my back.
Don't give me
your back. I need you to take the back push.
Back to the feet now. I'm not sure who knows where she is. She's in the octagon.
She can't possibly know where she is right now.
And they separate.
Leg kick.
Final 10 seconds of the fight. Oh, an instinctive land there as she goes to the jab, DC. Nicely done.
That jab is stopping her in her tracks and is not only a rangefinder. She is really damaging her opponent behind the jab.
All right, so there's the end of the round. We're going to get you some replays here. Her submission offense is outstanding, just unable to get it tight enough there.
She's such a great grappler. She manipulates you so well on the ground that you see why people try to avoid grappling with her at all costs. But she got the fight where she wanted to. She almost got the submission that would have ended the fight.
All right, so there's the horn. The round is over. And she is just not the tapping type. That submission looked pretty tight to me.
It looked very tight. And she looked surprised that her opponent did not tap, that her opponent did not go out. But she looked surprised. But she has to understand that she's in there with a very high-level grappler, and that happens in those types of situations.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. The judges score the contest 49-45, 48-46, and 48-46. Declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Waylee Magna John!
Well, you gotta figure her challenges are only gonna get stiffer from here, but she passed this test tonight. She is your winner by unanimous decision.
And she needed this, right? This goes to the maturity of her